Ans Westra's been taking photos of New Zealanders for more than six decades.
I'm happiest when I can just be the observer and take in what's happening.
Her work captures part of history and daily life, whether it be passers-by on Wellington's Cuba Street or a refugee family arriving in Auckland. The photos are candid and never sanitised, her subjects including a mongrel mob convention, the lives of sex workers.
Is your work political?
I always wanted to show the universality of people's feelings.
She came to New Zealand in the 50s from Holland.
I found a freedom that I could be myself and I could be away from the family and would have no one criticising me.
Intrigued by Māori, she joined Wellington cultural group Ngāti Pōneke and started attending hui throughout the country.
People would corner me and want to talk politics and their grievances about land and I would see all the life going on around me and wanting to photograph that rather than having to listen.
She became a freelancer, her most famous work a school book entitled Wash Day at the Pa. But the photos of a poor but happy rural Māori family ignited controversy. The Māori Women's Welfare League objected.
They really wanted to have it more scrubbed clean, more presentable.
Thousands of copies were destroyed.
And I had a lot of Māori themselves in my camp defending it and saying this is the childhood they remember.
Her recent work focusing on the scars we leave behind.
Just the audacity that you own the land and so you can do what you like with it, you can shape it and change it, and it sort of got to me I wanted to show people what they had destroyed.
Ans Westra is still working, planning a new book on the many children she's photographed over the decades. She's a companion of the New Zealand Order of Merit, received an Arts Foundation Icon Award and an honorary doctorate.
I've kept my Dutch accent and it sets me aside somewhat, so people will still think I've only just arrived. And it makes me more the outsider.
An outsider with an insider's view of Aotearoa. Michael Kropp, One News.